Thank you. We are confronted primarily with a moral issue. It is as old as the scriptures and is as clear as the American Constitution. The heart of the question is whether all Americans are to be afforded equal rights and equal opportunities. Whether we are going to treat our fellow Americans as we want to be treated. If an American, because his skin is dark, cannot eat lunch in a restaurant open to the public, if he cannot send his children to the best public school available, if he cannot vote for the public officials who represent him, if, in short, he cannot enjoy the full and free life which all of us want, then who among us would be content to have the color of his skin changed and stand in his place? Who among us would then be content with the counsels of patience and delay? 100 years of delay have passed since President Lincoln came to slaves, yet their heirs, their grandsons, are not fully free. They are not yet free from the bonds of injustice. They are not yet free from social and economic oppression. And this nation, for all its hopes and all its boasts, will not be fully free until all its citizens. Our freedom here at home. But are we to say to the world, much more importantly, to each other, this is the land of the free, except for the Negroes. We have no second-class citizens, except Negroes. We have no class, no caste system, no ghetto, no master race, except for the respect of Negroes.
Time to act. is snel ver. Je is nog gaan met wie we. Today, I weep for my country. I've watched the events of recent months with a heavy, heavy heart.
Thank you.